Calling Coruscant Spaceport Authority. Request permission to depart.
You are clear for departure. Have a pleasant flight.
I reviewed your service record before that ZR-57 op. Been meaning to discuss it with you. So you can kill Imperials. But that guerrilla mentality won't cut it in the big time.
You saw how I handled things on Ord Mantell. I know what I'm doing.
Taking on that SEP army single-handedly showed guts, not leadership. When I signed on with the Deadeyes, my CO was Lieutenant Vorn. Certified war hero, as decorated as they come. When he gave an order, we trusted it, followed it to the letter. A squad needs that kind of commitment to operate effectively.
I expect you to give me that same level of dedication.
I always give 100%. That's not the issue. Havoc Squad is the Republic's most elite outfit. We tackle the missions no one else can handle. Traitor or no, Tavis is a tough act to follow. You think you're up to it?
I wouldn't be leading Havoc Squad if I didn't...
Good answer. You've got confidence and plenty of raw talent. Maybe you'll pull this off.
Hey, hey, my number one sister in arms. Good to see you again, Lieutenant. Hope you're ready to crack some skulls because you've really got your work cut out for you on this one.
Tough missions are what I do best.
Oh, I've heard. You're starting to build up quite a rep. I'm getting a little jealous here.
Let's start with the accommodations. Port Raga is privately owned and officially neutral, but Wraith and her pals have taken over behind the scenes. My boys and I managed to tweak the sensors and keep your landing inconspicuous. But as soon as you step out of this hangar, it's party time.
Do you know where Kasul is being held?
We do. But there's some bad news on that front. Wraith has Kasul locked up in a hangar at the other end of the station. There's heavy security plus a big bonus. Explosives. Not enough bang to trash the station, of course. But plenty to ruin your day if you're in that hangar when they blow. Play it careful in there.
Thanks for the heads up, Sergeant.
You got it. I'd say it's time to get out there and get our senator back. What do you say?
Havoc Squad, move out.
It's about time.
See you on the other side, Lieutenant. Good luck.
Who the... Oh, you. I should have known Garza would try to keep all of this inside her twisted little family. Well, don't just stand there. You know how to defuse bombs, don't you? Ray said they'll explode if I leave the room. She has a remote detonator, too, so be quick!
Don't worry, sir. I'm gonna get you out of here.
I am not a child to be comforted, Lieutenant. That traitor was going to force me to go on record, saying the Senate officially abandoned Havoc Squad on Endo Prime.
I wouldn't mind knowing why you abandoned Havoc myself.
Havoc abandoned us! They invaded Endo Prime and incited a massive armed response from the Empire! Do you realize what will happen if this situation goes public? The Senate would be a firestorm. All of our judgments publicly called into question. And General Garza and Spec Force Division would be the first to burn.
This is the Senate's fault, not Spec Force's.
The Senate has done its duty. Garza's recklessness would reignite a war that the Republic cannot win. I'll admit, I'd like to see the look on that traitor's face when all of her bombs suddenly shut down. To watch that coward scurry away into the shadows when she realizes that her plans have failed would be priceless.
Rescuing you will reveal my presence to Wraith?
Surely Wraith's remote will tell her if the bombs are no longer working. Then she'll flee like the coward she is.
She won't escape me for long.
I should hope not. Now get to work on those bombs! Is it safe now? Are all of the bombs shut down?
I don't know about safe, but the bombs are disabled.
You know that's what I meant. I'm not a fool. Get on with it, Lieutenant. We still got to get out of this disgusting place. Go on, lead the way.
Well, look what we've got here, boys. Welcome to safety, Senator.
Who in the blazes are you? Mercenaries? This is ridiculous.
Oh, yeah. General Garza hires mercs to rescue Republic senators all the time.
These people are Spec Force troops in disguise, sir.
Fantastic. Now I almost wish they were mercenaries.
So, you rescued our charming friend here, obviously. Nice work. Any luck taking down Wraith?
She fled the scene before I could confront her.
Wraith must be even better than they say. We were watching every inch of this place. Nobody saw her leave.
Is someone going to get me a ship to Coruscant anytime soon?
Oh, don't worry, Your Honorable Eminent Senatorness. You're catching a ride with us.
Thanks for taking care of everything, Sergeant.
No problem at all. Besides, we're gonna have a fun time together, aren't we, Senator?
Yes, delightful.
Garza will want to hear from you ASAP, and we've got a ship to catch. Take care of yourself, okay?
Stay safe out there.
So long.
Lieutenant, I was just speaking with Sergeant Jaxo. Congratulations. Saving Senator Krazel will certainly help our affairs with the Senate. We needed someone to owe us a favor. Well done.
I just did my job.
You've accomplished something very important. Something beyond even your assignment to hunt down Tavis and the other traitors. You are in the field, Lieutenant. You see how far the Empire is reaching. A full attack isn't far off now. To keep the Empire's forces at bay, we need the Senate's support. We need allies.
I'm glad I could help out the cause.
Yes, you've done quite well in that regard. One thing, Lieutenant. I was disappointed to learn of Wraith's escape. She's capable of causing great turmoil.
You have my apologies, General. It won't happen again.
No, I'm sure it won't. Now, our technicians have decoded the first two sets of data from the Coruscant Relay. Your first two targets are Taris and Nar Shaddaa.
Can you tell me anything beyond the destinations?
Not at this time, I'm afraid. I'll try to collect more intelligence and give you a fuller briefing when you arrive at each location. Good luck, Garza out.
You think Havoc will start shaping into an actual squad soon?
I'll recruit more soldiers as soon as I find some Havoc-worthy candidates.
Makes sense. Once this unit starts growing, people's expectations of us, of you, are only gonna get bigger. That CO post could get real heavy, real quick.
Someone needs to run Havoc Squad.
Commanding a squad is no cakewalk. Nothing worse than having to choose between the success of the mission and the lives of your men. That said, a leader can't be soft on his troops. Coddling your men will only get them killed.
You get a point. I'll keep it in mind.
I'm sure you'll do fine. You've gotten us this far.
Come in, Lieutenant. This is General Garza. Do you copy?
I read you loud and clear, General.
I understand you've just landed on Taris. I've already contacted our local regimental commander, Colonel Gaff, to secure his support. Colonel Gaff doesn't know the specifics of your mission, only that he should assist you in every way possible. I'd like to keep it that way.
I'll keep quiet on the details, General.
That's for the best, Lieutenant. Taris is a dangerous and untamed wasteland. A Sith attack several centuries ago leveled every standing structure and virtually eradicated the local population. Where cities once rivaled Coruscant, only swamps and ruins remain. Reclaiming and rebuilding the planet has become an important symbolic goal for the Senate.
If there is any way I can aid in the reconstruction, I'll do it.
Of course. Just don't lose sight of your primary objective. That's all I have for you, Lieutenant. Report in when your operation is complete.
I'll contact you as soon as the job is done, General.
Well, well. General Garza graces us with her finest. At ease. I'm Colonel Gaff. These are my senior officers. Your CO sent orders to do whatever is necessary to support your mission. Of course, she didn't see fit to tell me what that mission is. You care to enlighten me?
I can't discuss the details.
Typical. Forget the reconstruction of Taris. I gotta shift everything around and help with some top-secret mission nonsense. Whatever Garza has you looking for, you won't find it on Taris. Nothing unusual has happened since I took command.
Patrol teams 3, 5, and 8. All lost, or without explanation.
Sergeant Thorne, I don't recall giving you permission to speak.
I wasn't speaking to you. I was speaking to the lieutenant, per General Garza's instructions. Are you ordering me to violate Code 73B and ignore the General's directive, Colonel?
Always got a regulation to quote, don't you, Sergeant Thorne?
If the Sergeant has information, I'll take it.
The matter was settled days ago. Taris is dangerous. Casualties are common on patrol teams. It's unfortunate, but not unusual, no matter what Sergeant Thorne says. Now, if you'll excuse me, I got a planet to run. Carry on with your secret mission. Just don't muck up anything important.
Apologies for the Colonel, Lieutenant. Not all men are meant to lead.
If you have information that could help me, I'd like to hear it.
Very well, Lieutenant. I'm Ilara Dawn, sir. Sergeant, First Class, Commander of Search and Rescue Squad 204. We have three full squads, all MIA on patrols. The situation is critical.
Do you have any idea what happened to these men?
I'm afraid not, Lieutenant. Casualties are common on swamp patrols. Rakghul attacks account for the majority, approximately 87%. However, SAR sweeps discovered no evidence of Rakghul activity in these instances. Someone else attacked those teams. If you're looking for unusual activity, then this is it, sir.
I appreciate your help, Sergeant.
I included the last known coordinates for the MIA patrols in my official incident report, Lieutenant. I'll load it into your datapad for your review. Taris falls under unexplored, unsecured territory protocols. All armor cams transmit to SAR Command. I'll contact you with developments.
Sounds like a plan, Sergeant.
Good luck, Lieutenant.
That was interesting. I've had drill instructors more relaxed than that woman. Not to mention that accent.
The locals can run things however they want. We've got our own mission to worry about.
You're the boss. Lead the way, Lieutenant.
Those are power converters, Lieutenant. Old ones. Any theories on how they got to that location?
The people who attacked our patrols may have dropped them.
Possible. None of the other patrols logged similar discoveries. Power converters come from ignition systems, engine parts. Takes work to remove them. Someone dropped these converters. Either the patrol or their attackers. We need more information to determine which.
Guess I'd better find more information.
I'll remain in contact, Lieutenant. Dawn out. More power converters. According to the logs, this patrol followed an entirely different route. Either both patrols recovered the same engine parts from separate locations, or the converters were dropped in both areas by one group. The attackers.
I think we're on the right track, Sergeant.
A specialist MO7 science officer could examine the converters to determine their source. We have such an officer on staff. I will notify him while you search the last coordinates.
Sounds like a plan, Sergeant.
Very well, Lieutenant. I'll proceed to Science Division at once. Good luck, Lieutenant. Lieutenant, status report. Are you injured?
Everything is fully operational.
Good. There's much to do. Your attackers were scavengers. Threat assessment reports classify them as a non-combatant group. That classification is clearly inaccurate. I'll notify command.
I don't see why these scavengers would strike at Republic personnel.
It's puzzling. Our forces are superior in numbers, training, and equipment. The scavengers must know that. Armed hostility against Republic personnel clearly justifies an immediate armed response, Lieutenant. It's your call.
Do we have any leads on the scavengers' HQ?
Orbital scan has just managed to pinpoint the location of the scavengers' compound. I'll scramble up my team and prep them immediately. We'll effect entry to the compound once you've created an opening.
See you on the other side, Sergeant.
Good luck, Lieutenant. Sergeant Dawn out.